All right, great. So the session is getting recorded. All right, so any doubts, any queries? So we're just waiting for 4 or 5 minutes for others to join in, and then we'll get started, guys, with search engine optimization. All right, so Rajiv, I believe you can hear me now. Okay, so Vibhor says, are there 7 types of ads? There are plenty, a lot of ads, different kind of ads, but I mean, these are majorly divided on the basis of marketing objectives, Vibhor. So I don't know the exact number. Definitely there would be 7 or more than that. So that's what we did cover in our session, right? If you remember, we had seen so many marketing objectives being there. Right. All right, so yeah, Pritham absolutely would get that. All right, and Vibhor says placement is different. Placement is actually all about where exactly is your ad getting visible. So within Facebook, the fair placement is only with the within the Facebook channel, Facebook network only. Placement, when we talk about Google AdWords, the websites where the advertisement is appearing, you know, it's at, where our advertisement is popping up, it's getting presented. Those are the placements. All right, so Preetam, to answer your question, 1 year validity is actually by Google. So don't worry, I'll get that validity increased also later on. So that's something which you get initially with the certificate's validity. It's just 1 year maximum which you get from Google. Google doesn't give any certificate which has more than 1 year validity. It's only the fundamentals exam which is valid for 2 years. But the other exams are valid for 1 year only. All right, great. So we have more people joining in. Hi, Guru Prasad. Hi. So we have Vibhor, Rajiv, Pritham, Nand Kumar. Hi, Nand Kumar, Guru, and Ashish. All right. So Pritham probably is not able to hear. All right. So, Guru, I'll check your cPanel later on. All right. All right, guys, let's get started with search engine optimization. Before I begin, any further doubts? Is everybody able to hear me? All right, thanks. So I believe Preetam is not able to hear me. All right, thanks, Nand Kumar. Thanks, Guru. All right, so when we talk about search engine optimization, guys, before I begin with my presentation, I'd just like to talk about certain basics which are there, and that'll clear a lot of insights into what search engine optimization is. So what we have done earlier when we have covered the Google AdWords part, how Google AdWords are being created, how the Google search ads rather are being created, and they're being made to come on the top. We have done that part. So let's say if I am today using search engines to do a lot of online shopping and I type in a keyword for doing online shopping, Guru says bringing our website on the top by organically. Absolutely, you're right. That's what it's all about. And if you see, when I type in a particular keyword, you know, if I'm an online shopper, I type in a keyword, buy iPhone 6, this is a query in which is there in my head, right? This is a query which in my head, and I am an online shopper. I type in that same query into the Google search box, because we know that these search engines are being created. They have come into the overall IT industry with a particular purpose. They are being presented by these organizations, whether it's Google or Bing, to offer a huge database to us. Now, we get a lot of database present to us whenever we try to search about something. I'm trying to search for a particular thing, which is iPhone 6. I want to buy that. Search engines have got a lot of database within their data centers. Out of that, they would pull out certain search results, certain websites. They would try and make it present to us. When I say present to us as in the search engine user, I have typed in a keyword, I'm a search engine user, and I'm being presented by the search engine certain search results. These top three search results have much better probability of getting maximum hits by all those people who are typing in this keyword. And once the maximum hits probability is there, then the probability of getting sales is also higher, right? More people visit your shop, more better chances that you will get conversions. Similarly, so now what was happening, we were actually talking about getting our website on the top for Google search results, right? Hi, Santosh. So with the help of Google search results, we were actually getting our website on the top. It was pretty easy by just paying into Google for every click. We were making sure that our advertisement comes on the top. So Pritham, if there is no sound, I did tell you log out and log in again and select on computer audio, please. All right. So like I was saying, you by just making use of Google AdWords, I would get my website on the top, right? Whether it's on the first position, second or the third, or maybe on the top right column, these are also the search ads, right? These are also the search ads which we have covered so far. All right, great, Pritham, you can hear me now. So on the right-hand side also, our advertisement can come if we are trying to use Google AdWords to get to be on the top. Now, what's happening with Google AdWords, what happens that we are paying to Google for every click. We are paying to Google for every click which is happening on our ad. This comes out to be, proves to be very expensive affair, guys. But the overall benefit is that if today I want my website to be on the top, Google AdWords can really help me in doing that. There is another way through which we can get our website on the top. What is that on the top right-hand side? That is the Google Shopping Ads. These are Google Shopping Ads, which are called PLA ads. So for that, you need e-commerce website. So once you have e-commerce websites, then you can connect your website with the Google AdWords and they come on the top. Hi, Pankaj. Right. So even these are paid ads, guys. And the ones on the right-hand sides are the paid listings. Even on the top three ones are the paid listings. So Vibhor says, any idea on ratio of clicks PPC versus SEO? All right, sure, I'll tell you. Because ads always on the top value addition of 60 to 70% of the clicks are actually on the SEO. I'm coming on to that, so let me explain the basics. But the answer is 60 to 70% clicks are from the SEO report, right? And 30% are on the ads, because not many people tend to click on the ads. They really sort of scare, you know, they are scary for some people. They definitely feel that, you know, it's, they are probably going to get into some scam if they would click on this. So like I was telling you, if these ads, if I'm trying to get my website on the top today, if I plan to do that because I want sales, I get that on the top. I am paying to Google every time for every click. Now, either my website is going to be on the top or on the right hand side. Hi, Anuj. So, either it's going to be on the top or on the right hand side. But today, if I decide that I don't want to pay even a single penny to Google, I want sales and traffic. First of all, traffic. And through traffic, I want people coming into my website, showing some interest. And after showing in some interest, those visitors might turn up into leads, prospective leads or prospective sales, and then ultimately leading into a paying customer. That's what happened in the real-time scenario also. Let's say, for an example, if we visit a particular grocery store or a departmental store like Big Bazaar, just to give you an example, not everybody buys and stuff, right? there are many shoppers who haven't decided really what do they want. There are many people who have just entered with an objective of buying a single thing, and they end up buying a lot of things. So different kind of audience all in together. Similarly, over here also, there are plenty of people who visit your website, but not everybody would buy. If there are 100 hits on your website for a num for 1 hour, not all those 100 would buy from your website. Probably just 10 people would buy it, or probably just 2 people are going to buy it. That's a sort of a conversion. In e-commerce industry, 4 to 5% is a good conversion rate, guys. All right. So I was telling you, these particular top search results are the Google ads, and the ones which are on the bottom, where you don't see the ad symbol, are called the organic results. These are the search results only. These are only web pages only, which are actually ranking up over here. How can we get our website on the top, like the way Apple has got, or Snapdeal has got their website on the top, or Amazon has got their website on the top? There is a certain mechanism to it. There's a certain digital marketing activity which is being done, and that is called SEO, guys, which stands for Search Engine Optimization. What is happening? We are trying to optimize our website for the search engines. If we would make our website rank higher on the organic list results, these are the organic results, organic or unpaid. These are different names. So organic, unpaid, or natural listings, or the SEO listings, guys. So these are the few names which are, given to a same thing. Same thing when I say these ones, which are not the ads one. No matter how many people come on this particular search result page, this is a search engine result page, guys. If I scroll further down, this is number one. This is a result page. This is another second search engine result page. It's actually called SERPS. SERPS stands for Search Engine Results Page. All right, absolutely. That was SERPS 1, and this is SERPS 2. This is Search Engine Result Page 2. In every SERP, there are paid search results. This is one search result, right? This is not the result page. In every result page, there are different kind of results, search engine results. These are the paid ones, and these are the unpaid ones. And for every search engine result page, you would get to see maximum 10 and minimum 10 natural listing, guys. When I say natural, these are the organic listings. Natural listings are organic. Organic and inorganic, absolutely. Whatever you call it, paid and unpaid, or whatever names you want to give them. Right. So what we are going to cover right now is we're going to understand how can we get our website on the top of the organic listings. So every SERP, Google PPC ad will appear. Not really. Great question. So I have a question from Guru. Guru says, for every search engine result page, will the Google PPC ad appear? Not really. If today I see it for another keyword, let's say, I type in buy drugs. Okay, so for drugs it's coming, and I thought not many people are there. So a lot depends. No, for IRCTC it's very competitive. For IRCTC definitely. Okay, they're not there. All right. So right. So for many keywords there are no advertisements. It depends a lot on how many people are trying to get their website on the top for a particular keyword, right? So that's the overall objective, guys, behind search engine optimization, that your audience type in a particular keyword, and that keyword relates to what you also offer. The government sites, absolutely, Anuj. Yeah, so government sites don't really promote them quite a lot, and keywords related to them are non-competitive ones. The report says maybe just information a person might be looking for. Absolutely. So not every keyword will have the paid ads, and unpaid search results are definitely going to be there every time, right? So you have the unpaid search results over here. The store Apple, the Snapdeal, the Amazon, all are over here. All right. So once we now the objective, guys, with digital marketing, wherever you will go. Now all of you have a different objective to meet. Some of you are trying to get into digital marketing industry. Some of you are already there in the industry but trying to refine your overall knowledge. So, okay, so Vibhor says Google enemy sites. You might say that. So, but why would the enemy sites, but they would rank it? So, it may be just information a person might be looking at. Absolutely. Now, like I said, there are various ways, there are various reasons for which you guys are over here. You know, some of you are over here to really upscale and uplift your career into the digital marketing field. Some of you are here to actually get into the digital marketing field. No matter whatever your overall objective may be, whether you're trying to get your own stuff built up as a freelancer or you're trying to join in any agency, but whatever the case may be, SEO is something which is very common, guys. SEO is the most famous, I would say, most famous or most time-taking or most the biggest chunk of the digital marketing budget goes into search engine optimization. If you don't know SEO, then probably you're missing out on a lot of stuff about digital marketing. This is the very first most thing, guys, which every, excuse me, digital marketer actually learns about most of the times. Most of the time it happens. All right. So now we will understand how can we get our web page on the top. Let's try to learn these things step by step. Hi, Nitin. So very first thing, if we are trying to get our website on the top, guys, which is, let's say Snapdeal has done that. Snapdeal would have done SEO in two different major things. One, so SEO is divided into two major different things. One is called on-page optimization, guys. On-page optimization. So I'll be using the slides and it'll be much more clean, simple for you. And off-page optimization. So these are the two major pillars, guys, of search engine optimization, which one has to really do in order to get their website on the top. No matter how many people come and click on the Snapdeal version, the Snapdeal search result, Snapdeal doesn't have to pay even a single penny. Snapdeal won't pay even a 1 rupee or $1 or 1 cent for getting so many hits. So it's almost like a free thing, but it's just, it doesn't mean that you can get your website on the top very easily. I'll tell you what exactly on page stands for. The investment which is needed, guys, in SEO is majorly from the human effort. So a lot of people, a good team is actually needed to get your website on the top. A lot depend on kind of website, the kind of, the kind of keyword which you're actually targeting for. So if you're targeting for a highly competitive keyword, then it will take a lot of time and effort to get your website on the top. And if it's a competitive keyword, probably a good number of SEO professionals' salary would be invested. What was happening in Google AdWords, the amount of investment which you're doing is actually the amount which you're majorly paying to Google, or maybe the salary of the Google's search Google AdWords professional. So let's say if you are running an agency or whatever, or maybe you are running your business and you're hiring a particular person to take care of the digital marketing activities, then in Google search ads, you would be paying to that person who would be making advertisements for you, handling it, managing it, and also a lot larger chunk of your digital marketing budget will be spent across on the amount of money which Google will actually charge you. In this case, I repeat, Google charges you a lot of money, major chunk that goes over there. And with search engine optimization listings, it's majorly the amount of money which you would be incurring on the overall team. And like I said, there are two major pillars to SEO, guys. I've already written that down in the search window, on page optimization and off page. These are the two major pillars, right? When we'll talk about these two major pillars, one after another, and we'll take them in detail, that's what overall on page optimization is all about. Whenever we talk about SEO, we try to get the web, try to get every web page optimized, guys. We never optimize the websites. We optimize the web pages. Any idea, guys, what on page would mean? So I have an answer from Vibhor. Vibhor says on page is about making it user friendly, as in the website, making website user friendly. Anybody else? So let me ask question, guys, so that it's not only me who will keep on chatting. I would want participation from each one of you. Any idea, guys, what do you understand by on-page optimization? So Shubham says On page includes web design layout. All right, thanks. Anuj says like on role job. All right, thanks, Anuj. Santosh says content in navigation. Absolutely, Santosh, thank you. Shubham says keyword. All right, Shubham. Title tag says Shubham. Ashish says alt tag. Right, meta tag. Right, says Shubham. Ashish says meta tags. Nitin says changes in the website. Absolutely. Great. Thank you so much, guys, for participating. Anybody else? Any doubts or any queries also somebody has? Feel free to ask me, guys. So Nandkumar, Rajiv, Pritam, Pankaj. So Shubham says backlinks. Okay. Changes in website. So backlink is part of off page, basically, Shubham. So page loading time. Right. Sure, Guru. Yeah. So any doubt or any queries so far? The basics which I've already told you about the categorization, you can let me know. Now on page, guys, most of you have said that right. Like the word says on page. The word says on page. RSS coming on page. RSS has actually got discontinued, Pritham, but it was part of on page for sure. It says on page, changes on the web page. Any change which you make on the web page is becomes part of on-page optimization, guys. Now, to give you an example, on-page optimization example is like making changes in the content of the website. Aged domain, absolutely. The domain age also become parts of it. The tags part, absolutely. So let's say this is the website, guys, which is snapdeal.com, which is ranking higher. I'll open that in the new tab and make you see what changes, what all on-page activities would this Snapdeal SEO team. So Snapdeal SEO team would have done really something great because of which they're on the top. I hope you would agree to that. These guys are doing something really great. Snapdeal guys is doing something really great because of which they're on the top, and they have really got Flipkart behind that, them behind them. They have got eBay behind them. They have got Amazon behind them, Infibeam, MySmartPrice. These all websites are not able to rank high as Snapdeal. So what SEO team of Snapdeal would have done in terms of on page, guys, even the other websites would have done is this. So let me show you this. You can see on the web page what kind of changes could have been done. Overall layout, you can see the content part. So the content part, the image part, if there is any change to the overall website on the overall web page, that forms part of on page. We'll talk about all those things in detail, guys. There are certain things called tags also, which most of you have mentioned about it. So tags are something which are part of the overall web page. Every web page has certain tags, right? I'll show you that. And in other ways, and the other pillar, guys, which is off page. Now, what exactly do we mean by off page, guys? What is your overall understanding by the second pillar of SEO, which is off-page optimization? So looking for more answers. All right, so Ashish says backlink, Santosh says backlink, absolutely. Shubham says backlink, bookmarking, right? Pankaj says blog, absolutely. Preetam says blog commenting, right? Preetam, you can type in your comments in public also. No problem. Vibhor says linking your sites to others, absolutely. Nitin says, so all of you know that. Why am I teaching them? Right. So great, guys. Thank you so much. All of you already know that. You have done your homework. And I believe the classes which you guys are taking at the Ghaziabad and also in the Delhi. So there are some of you from the Ghaziabad center, and some of you from the online sessions, and some of you are also from the Delhi center, I believe. So we do Google at the same time also. Yeah, right. So Guru says article submission. Absolutely. So I couldn't understand before what you said. We do Google at the same time also. Okay. While okay, when I ask you a question, you search it on the Google, you mean to say, all right, smart people, So this shows that you are great digital marketers. Right. Good. So when you're doing the Googling around, then every website will have a different story altogether, I'll tell you. Now, for each one of you, when I talk about, just to check, there is someone who's not able to hear me, I believe. All right. So with off-page optimization, guys, as the name suggests, off-page, anything which is outside the website. So I'll take that. So anything which is outside the website and not done on the web pages. For an example, guys, it's all about getting backlinks. And what are backlinks? Let me show you that. Let's say if I open a website, Search Engine Journal, or in a layman language, guys, let's say today, after attending this session to which you are doing, after attending today's session, you guys go back and start writing something within your blog. Let's say today, all of you have either got a blog or a website where you write in something or the other. You are really fond of writing in a lot of stuff. You start writing about your experience you had with the SEO class today with Nick Bartla, which is me. So you start writing that today I had attended search engine optimization session, which was conducted by Mr. Nick Bartla. And within all your text, you actually take a particular word and hyperlink it. When I say hyperlink it, it's like this. So Santosh says display ad is similar to backlinks. These actually give you some sort of a backlink weightage. Absolutely, Santosh, you're right. The concept is very similar. From third-party sites, there are certain websites which are referring to your main website, so they are backlinks only, right? And Santosh, your answer question is answered. Vibhor says we talk about DMP on Facebook, we'll do it for you. Absolutely, absolutely. So let's say today, after attending today's session, you guys even write in something on your Facebook profile, you know, and you give a backlink of DM Pathshala website. So it's a backlink which you have done for you, for my website, right? So let's say I open a particular article which is on Search Engine Journal. So Vibhor, you gave a very good example, and Santosh, the question which you've asked, that's also a backlink. Third-party websites are referring to you is a backlink. And if you see, this is the content. Let's say you have written all the content which you wanted, and within this content, this particular text is not clickable, but this particular text is clickable, right? Then you have the third, second, another one which is clickable. Then you have another one which is clickable. Let's say if I click on this one, which is search metric one, what happens? Another overall URL opens up, which is searchmetrics.com. The text was, the overall blog was over there on Search Engine Journal domain. The domain which was there, which is Search Engine Journal domain, and it was an internal web page. Within the internal web page, guys, if somebody clicks on the search metrics URL, sorry, the text, the hyperlink, then the other third party website opens up. Now, what is happening? Search Engine Journal website is giving a backlink, guys, to the search metrics. Search metrics website is going to get benefit out of it. That's in plain simple language. Off page is all about, guys, and we'll talk about all of them, all these things in detail. So this is a major brief about on page and off page. On page is all about making changes on the website content, overall pictures, images, the tags, the code part. And with off page, you're not touching your website at all, but you're trying to optimize it by ranking it higher. I mean, you're optimizing it by with the help of backlinks and making it rank higher, right? So you're getting backlinks. So Vibhor says, does on page has something to do with font also? Nothing. The font really doesn't really help you. And Santosh says, please throw some light on blog sometime. Okay, which blog as in, Santosh? When you say blog as in, which blog? So we did talk about how to blog. All right, sure. We'll have a session on that. Sure. Absolutely. So maybe not this one, since we are doing the SEO part, but we'll have a separate session on that also. But that is something which is very much related. Santosh, I'll take that within the on-page optimization only. All right. So coming on to on-page optimization, starting with on-page optimization, like I said, changes made on the website is something which is needed. Now, once we start a search engine optimization, guys, how do we analyze or how do we evaluate whether SEO is a great digital marketing activity for my brand or not? So let me give you an example. Today I'm owning, let's say, a website which offers medicines online. You know, I'm selling medicines online, and so now, okay, an online store will definitely have a really importance on this SEO part. Let me give you an example of something else. I'm a car garage, all right? So I own a car garage, and today I decide that I have to make a decision whether I should do SEO or not. How would I make a decision? So there is nothing technical. You just have to think logically. I own a car garage. Do you think I should invest on SEO? If yes, why? If no, why? And so this is one question, yes or no, and why? And the other question is, how would you evaluate whether I should invest in SEO or not? So let's say all of you are marketers. You all are marketers. You all are digital marketers or overall marketers. And I am a car garage owner. And some of you have actually met me in an elevator or maybe in a networking event. And you tell me that you are a digital marketer. And would you recommend me doing SEO? If yes, why? If no, why? And how would you evaluate? So Vibhor says SEO means new people will come to know about you. All right. So do you think it should be done for me? I am a car garage owner. So Guru says yes. Anuj says yes. All right. Vibhor says must. It is a must. All right. So I've got three yeses. Anybody else? Santosh says people are searching their needs on Google. Right. You're coming very close, Santosh. Absolutely. So Vibhor, Santosh, have the both of you have the same meaning that if people are searching for you, people are searching for their needs on Google. But do you think the products and services, let's say I'm a car garage owner and I offer services like brake repair or AC repair, or I offer services like engine refurbishing, whatever, or car wash or whatnot. So car wash and all that kind of thing. So Nitin says yes, targeting potential customer. All right. So I've got all yeses. Vibhor says people will come to know who does not even live close to you. All right. Sure, Vibhor. But you may be in some 10th page. All right. Sure. Okay. Now let me explain more further. Now since I'm offering services like car wash or brake repair or AC repair of all these automobiles, or maybe the car, I have a car garage, and it is a local business, all right, and it is a local business which is somewhat catering to audience which is part of West Delhi, all right. So and I know that West Delhi audience is only who are going to come to me. Now why all of you have said yes. All of you have said that I should be doing SEO. Now, why you have said that, you have given answers to it, that people will come to know about me. People are always checking for their needs. So my website should be in front of them. And Santosh says you need to come on the first page, but you may be in the 7th, 10th page. All right. So do local SEO. Absolutely. Guru says if someone is searching for some work related garage work, then if we did the SEO, definitely help. You're getting very close to that, Guru. So won't you really, guys, try to understand my audience? Is my audience using internet or not? So local SEO, Pritham is like, Pritham, you can type in the public chat also, which is okay, right? So do local SEO. Vibhor says yes. Santosh says yes. So now I'll come into the local SEO part. It's all about, first of all, analyzing. If I have to get an answer whether SEO is a great investment for me, which is a car garage owner, I have to, first of all, understand the overall browsing behavior, the internet usage behavior of my audience. What if the overall, all those people who come to my place have never ever used internet? So do you think would that be a great thing to do? So I'm saying if I do a sort of a research, whether those people who are always looking for car wash or always looking for AC repair, they always get to know about new places, or their internet usage is simply zero. They don't use internet at all. Do you think then again SEO is a great investment for me? So I'm saying online browsing behavior is something which needs to be known, right? So Anuj says no, Rajiv says no. No, in that case, no. Absolutely. So that's why I guys said that if I have to evaluate whether SEO is a great investment for me or not, I have to first of all check for online browsing behavior, or you can say online media consumption pattern of my target group. So you cannot do that for the entire group, but probably you can check it for a certain section of your target group. So Vibhor says, I will get educated customers who will be ready to shell out more money. Now, this is again an assumption, Vibhor. Even if I see that the educated customers are also, I am assuming that educated customer would actually have more money and they would search for garage services. You never know. Maybe these people who have got a lot of money, they would actually just give the car keys to their chauffeurs, to their drivers, and say, tell them that please go ahead and look for a good place where you can get the car wash done, right? So a small primary research, absolutely. Then how to do the analyzation, whether your end audience would be using the search engines or not, are they using or not, is simply by asking them. That's it. That this is something which I actually do it for all my clients. So Nitin says segmentation is essential. According, we need to advertise. Yeah, that's with the paid ads, absolutely, Nitin. And with this one, if you are trying to make a judgment, if you're trying to analyze whether you should invest on SEO or not, I always try and tell my client that please check with your end audience, are they really spending time on the internet or not? So let's say, okay, now the answer was no if my audience is not spending time at all on internet. I come to know that they spend a lot of time on televisions, they spend a lot of time watching movies in the cinema halls, they spend a lot of time in listening to radios, they spend a lot of time in doing something or the other, driving a lot on the streets. They are the drivers. Only the drivers make the judgment, Drivers make the judgment where the car should get washed. The drivers make the judgment whether where the AC should get repaired or not. The car owners are not making the judgment. All right. So you can do keyword research. Absolutely. So how to do the right. So with keyword analysis also, with keyword the tool also, we can get to know. I'll show you the keyword tool. But I hope you have got the point. You can just simply go ahead and talk to all those people who are already coming to your garage. The kind of audience which are coming to your particular shop or to your garage, whatever the case may be, you can start asking them what sort of usage they have. Now, let's say situation two, guys. I am giving you a situation two. Now, if I get to know that overall my audience is using internet, all right. Now, all those people who are coming to my garage for getting their cars AC repaired or they're getting their cars washed, I get to know that yes, they're using internet. Hear me out properly, they're using internet. Then do you think I have done my part right and I should go ahead and simply start working on the search engine optimization? And I should park my money, I should spend money on the SEO campaign if my end audience is spending time is doing a lot of consumption on the internet. Yes, says Santosh. Yes, says Anuj. Yes, says Guru. All right, so I repeat, my end audience is spending time on the internet, so I should do the investment on SEO. So all of you have said that yes. Vibhor says, but low competition means easy SEO, first mover advantage. Yeah, I'll come on to the competition point. Don't worry. So Dhruv says yes. All right. Pankaj says not only end users, there should be competitor or analysis. Absolutely, there should be competitor analysis also. Yes. All right. So only local SEO. Absolutely, Anuj. Or I have someone by the name of Android attendee. If you can change your name, that'll be great. All right, guys. So let me tell you one thing. That's not the end of the decision. So Nitin says, but again, the decision are on drivers in case of garage, right? So let's say, when I ask these garage, sorry, these drivers, who are coming onto my particular garage. In scenario one, I have already told you that they are not spending it. They don't use internet at all. They don't know. So the answer was no, not to spend on SEO. Now, scenario two, I'm assuming, or I get to know, sorry, I'm not assuming, I get to know from these drivers that they're spending time on internet. They do surf over the internet. Then is it good to just make an investment on SEO? All of you said yes. But the answer is that's not the end of the story, guys. The answer is no, absolutely. Why I'll tell you. because I have to further go and do more analysis and asking them if they are using internet, what part of internet are they using? Are they using search engines or not? Because SEO is very specific to search engines. What if they're spending a lot of time on porn sites? You never know. These are drivers, right? Or what if they're spending a lot of time on Facebook? You know, somebody told them that yes, Facebook is the thing, which and they have really understood about it. So look for people with relevant searches. Look for the co answer to the question, are they using search engines or not? Are they using search engines for making decision of what place to get their car washed, for making decisions on questions like where to get their car's air conditioned serviced? You know, if they are actually using search engines, then also it's not the end of the story. Then you probably need to ask them again, do you use search engines for finding all these car garages? You know, maybe for good porn. Absolutely, they might be using that. You know, the driver community might be using internet only for the porn stuff, or they might be using it only for the social networking part. But if they're not using for the search engines, then you are really not you've not come to the right answer. You really need to first dig down into the exact answers of the questions which would give you the overall. Just a sec, guys. So questions which will help you understand whether it's a great decision to invest in SEO or not. So if they are using internet, let's say, and after you getting to know that they are using search engines a lot within the internet, and they're using search engines not for just stupid stuff or finding a lot of other stupid stuff, but also they're using search engines for finding garage, you know, for finding a place where they can get their cars washed, or for a place to get their cars air conditioned serviced, or whatnot, and what else, right? If they're doing it, then it makes sense. So again, in this case, reference is used to do no SEO. Absolutely. Till the time you don't get to know whether they are using search engines for searching for my product or services, then it doesn't make really sense. So people looking for good car service, yeah, right. So once I get to know about that, then the next point comes in, guys, to start analyzing what all keywords would this audience type in. You know, this is a primary thing which you have to really do by asking them verbally, you know, over the phone, over the email, or face to face. These kind of activities have to be done. Once it's been done, you can probably ask 10 set of people what sort of keywords do they type in. Maybe they would tell you that they type in keywords like car wash showroom. So let's say car wash showroom in West Delhi. Maybe that's the kind of keyword, or AC maintenance. So since it's a local thing, so definitely people generally type in with geographic location also, or maybe AC repair shop or AC repair garage. So now this is something which we again don't need to assume. We have to ask our end audience. The base keywords, these are the base keywords. We would ask best car services in West, absolutely. So, you know, these are kind of keywords which your end audience might type in. We are assuming, but we are not sure. Once you get to know from your end audience that yes, they are typing in such kind of keywords, you can take those keywords and do a keyword analysis. Step one, guys, within on-page optimization is keyword research. So these are the steps which we are going to talk about in our entire session today, which is part of the on-page optimization. So after analyzing, I've told you the difference between the SEO and the paid and the unpaid search results. I've told you the difference between a search result and a search engine results page. I've also told you what are the two major components of SEO, which is on-page and off-page. And right now in today's session, we are talking about on-page. And before investing in money into SEO, what sort of questions do you really need to ask your end audience? I've told you about that also, right? So people usually go with dealers for any fault. Absolutely, they do. You're right, Nitin. And so once you have got to know, let's say, the basic keywords, the keyword analysis is step one. after doing the overall cross-portioning to your end customer. And for doing keyword analysis, guys, the keyword planner tool is one which is used the most. I'll show you that. You need your Google, your Gmail account credentials to actually work on Google Keyword Planner. What is this? What this tool actually tells you, this tool which Google has provided gives you a lot of permutation and combinations of keywords which are there. When I say permutation combination, maybe a lot of choices of keywords which your end audience might have typed in, or people would have typed in the past 1 month, 2 months, 6 months, or 1 year. So once you click on the Keyword Planner URL which I have given you, this is the first thing which you will get to see. And when you click on search for new keywords using a phrase, that's one thing which you really need to do. And enter one or more of the following. So let's say car wash services. Let's say that's a keyword. And the website I would have to type in, and that's what the landing page. So I would have to type in my particular website. So let's say I don't have a website related to this. So let me search and then take a website from there. All right, so let's say this is the key, this is the website, guys. All right, I type in the website. I'm taking a dummy website, I'm taking one of the examples. So I type in speedcarwash.com, I type in car wash services. Am I doing it for Delhi or for India? Let's say if I'm targeting overall India, I can just type that across and then click on get ideas. You can also select the category, guys. You can choose what is the right category. So it'll take me some time to decide on that. You can simply go ahead and select the right category yourself at a later stage. I click on get ideas. All right, so Guru says website is not mandatory. Yeah, website is not mandatory. You're absolutely right. So Carnation is doing a great job. Absolutely, yeah. Mr. Jagdi, Mr. Khattar, right? From Maruti. Yeah, all right. So what you can see over here is the XMD, absolutely right. So ad group ideas, don't look at the ad group ideas, guys, because this tool is majorly used by the Google Ads, paid ads. So we don't have to, we are not doing that, but we are taking help of this tool for SEO also. When the other thing which we have to do, we don't have to click on ad group ideas, we have to look at the keyword ideas. When I click on keyword ideas, like I said, you would get a lot of permutation combination of keywords which people type in while looking for services like yours. The services which you're offering, the car wash services, there are different ways through which people actually search for your products and services, your services majorly. Ignore the bid part also, guys, because this was majorly part of the PPC campaigns. All we have to really look at is the keywords first, then second thing is the average monthly search, and the third is the competition. Now, how do we analyze, how do we get which all keywords really make sense for us, for our website, to make our website optimize, is first of all, take all these keywords in an Excel sheet first. It's all high competition. Yes, it is. So I'll tell you, if there it's all high competition, what is the way to do it? You can download all these things, download all the keywords by clicking on this download ideas in an Excel sheet. Click on download and the Excel sheet will start. So where did you click the keyword planner to get into this? I missed it. I did send you the Google Keyword Planner URL, Santosh. If you scroll up in the chat window, it was google.com/keyword planner. Yeah, it's 801, right? So Santosh, does that answer your question? Where did you click in the keyword planner to get this? I missed. All right. No, after clicking the URL. All right. Let me go back. Let me go back and show you again. So I go back. All right. So I typed in the keyword. Santosh, have a track. I mean, have a look of what I'm doing. The product, service, one of the base keyword, which I had there told you that my client would have told you, my customer, end customers might have told you. And this window came in with the help of that URL. All right. Let me tell you what I did. I had the direct URL, that's why I had typed in. So go to google.com, Santosh, and type in Google keyword planner. All right. So once you get that, the very first one, once you click on the keyword planner, sign in to AdWords. And once you sign in, that same thing will pop up. Right, so over here, all the same thing I had done, which is, so this was the one I clicked on search for new keywords, and when I clicked on this, I typed in the product service keyword, the landing page, the product category, right? That's what I did in the before tab, and I had targeting India, and then I click on get ideas, right? So when I clicked on get ideas, I came over here. All right, great. Thanks, Santosh. So what you can see, there are plenty of keywords, guys. So you can take all those keywords within an Excel sheet. I have downloaded that. Or else, let's say just for example's sake, I'm letting you know, these are all permutation combinations of keywords which people have typed in on Google. So this is the actual stats and actual figures, guys. All those who have typed in this keyword, I mean, who have looked in for these services, they have typed in this keyword. And average monthly searches have been 1600. And competition, when I say competition, there are almost, I mean, there are plenty of websites which are targeting for this keyword. When I say competition is high, it means a lot of websites are really trying to get their get themselves on the top. So Pawan says, take it to make Excel file. Take it to make Excel file. Let me open the Excel file. Is that what you're saying? All right, so I'm opening the Excel file. So first of all, while how to download, all right, okay. So let me show you again. So can you see the download ideas, guys, option? Click on the download ideas. Once you click over there, it will say Excel CSV. Yes, go ahead and click on download. It'll start downloading. Okay, it got failed. Not really sure why. I do it again. All right, now it's happening. It says your download is now available, save file. I click on save file, and within the new a new tab opens up, and this file gets downloaded across here. All right, I go ahead and click over here, and you can see all the keywords. So all the keywords are right up here. I really don't need these things. I would go ahead and delete them. What I need to know is about the keyword. First of all, when we are trying to, guys, when we are trying to freeze down on what all keywords we need to get our website on the top, we have to first of all check from the relevancy of the keyword, then from the monthly searches, and third thing is the competition, guys. So Vibhor says, why important share organic is blank? Oh, they actually are not able to give you more information on the share organic part. That's why they're not able to take all that data. And Guru says it is something according to website means they have some offer or services on car wash machine. If we remove the website, it'll show generally. Absolutely. If we remove the website, then certain keywords won't actually come in, but the monthly search will always be the same, Guru. The monthly searches will never get affected. The competition will never get affected. Only certain keyword options won't come in, and not much of a difference. Right. So once you get all these keywords, guys, look at all of them. You know, this is a human effort which is needed. So you have to look at all of them step by step and see whether this one really makes sense to my business or not. Car wash services, absolutely it does. Car washing services, car washing machines. So see, I'm not selling a washing machine. I'm not selling a washing machine, so that's why I'm gonna crap this. I don't need this, right? So I'm probably gonna make it red. So automatic car washing machine, I don't need that machine. Equipment, I'm not selling it. Car wash service is absolutely something which I am doing it. Car washing, I'm doing it. Car washing machine price, I'm not selling that. This is not something which I'm selling.
So just to give you an example, is within these 10 top keywords, only three, one, two, and three keywords is something which are relevant. Now, after these three relevant keywords, I'll take out all the relevant keywords guys out of this guy, right? From my business perspective, I would see what is the overall competition for these keywords and the monthly searches. Now, the second thing is monthly searches. I have to see for those keywords which have higher monthly searches and lower competition. You can see for these three keywords, guys, which are these two and the first one, the keyword with lesser competition is 0.631. It's on the scale of 0 to 1. 0.63 has the lower competition. Then car wash service is bit higher, and 0.997 is much higher. But if I have to really select out of this, my website is fairly new, I would look for a web for a keyword which is lesser on the competition side. Which is lesser on the comp Okay, when it says low competition, it means lesser websites are trying to rank their website or trying to get their search, their advertisement up for this keyword. So websites which are not targeting for this keyword for getting their website in the paid ads or in the search results also. So reverse is most relevant are more expensive. How to choose? Well, absolutely. If more relevance are more expensive, the best way to really go ahead and choose, the perfect strategy is to always look at longer key phrases. So let's say car, you can do a search again. Car wash services in West Delhi. You know, if you have a local, what do you say, a business, then use the geographic words. It will have low competition and lower price and easy to rank and much more conversion related ones. It's a thumb rule, guys. The longer the key phrase, the longer the keyword with more number of key phrases. You know, these are key phrases. Car is one of the key phrase. Wash is another one. Service is another one. West is another one. Delhi is another one. So they're like five, six key phrases within a keyword. If you have long tail keywords, you know, with geographic areas, they are much easy to rank. They are much easy to, I mean, they are lesser expensive in Google AdWords also, and they are more conversion related ones. So, Pawan says, as they are easy to rank, yes, Vibhor says long tail and Vibhor says, but it will have lesser important share, impression share. Absolutely, they will have. See, I tell you what, people who are very much decided on buying a particular stuff. Today I decide that I want to buy iPhone 6 and 16 GB, and that too within the Connaught Place region I'm looking at, right? So I would type in a keyword like buy iPhone 6 16 GB in Connaught Place. Then I'm typing it very specific. Or if I'm trying to buy a specific laptop, I would type in the even product number of that particular laptop because I'm very sure on what I have to buy. People who are just trying to do a research, they would type in good laptops, comparison of laptops, or laptops by Lenovo, laptops by Compaq. You know, these kind of keywords are very generic, very information seeking keywords. And information seeking keywords or generic keywords gives you a lot of keywords, a lot of traffic, a lot of impressions, but the conversions are less. At the end of the day, what are you looking at? Are you looking at a lot of traffic or are you looking at a lot of sales? If I tell you that I'll give you a lot of traffic on your website, but your sales are not going to be that huge, would you prefer that? So Guru says how they arrive, one, two. Okay, this is on the basis of data, Guru. On the back end, they know how many websites are trying to get their websites on the top of these keywords. So Anuj says no. Pawan says no. Pawan says no. Right, absolutely. So Guru, the answer is okay. You've got the answer. So absolutely. See, you're not always looking for people coming onto your website and just roaming around your website and then not buying anything from you. You're looking for buying stuff also. So I always prefer if your website is fairly new, go for very targeted longer key phrases. Maybe you will get just two people in the overall month from those keywords, but may and the chances are that those two people who are coming onto your website with the help of those longer key phrases, they will buy things from your website. This is something which has been seen, which has been really experiment, and I have seen for all of my clients. I might give them traffic of 50 people in a day, but out of 50, 10 people actually buy from them, as compared to any other search engine optimizer who give them 5,000 traffic in a day and only 5 people are buying from them. Now, what is a better situation? Better situation is that where you're getting maximum sales, right? So this is the overall way, guys. You look at lesser competition and good monthly searches and the relevancy part. Once you have decided on the relevancy, then go with the average monthly searches and the competition. If let's say the competition is same, then it's one and one, then you can really select for that one which has got more monthly searches. Absolutely, you're looking for maximum sales. So all in all, that's the funda of looking at keyword, guys. Now, once the keyword have been pulled out, let's say you have pulled out 100 keywords. 100 keywords have been pulled out by you, then next thing is to actually go for URL mapping, guys. I'll show you how URL mapping works. For every URL, guys, I always recommend all my students to go for minimum 2 to maximum 3 keywords. Maximum 3 keywords per URL. For every URL, maximum 3 keywords should be targeted. Why is that? Because you can concentrate your efforts of search engine optimization for all the keywords. Let me show you with the help of an example which I did for one of my client how the URL mapping was being done. All right, I go to Dropbox and then all right, so if you see for this particular client of mine, which is into real estate, I had first of all got the list of keywords, and for every keyword, I had sort of did a mapping in terms of which particular page for which particular keyword. So if I go further down, some of the generic ones are on the home page, then some other generic one on a different, what's different web page. And the Gurgaon related one keyword on the Gurgaon related web page, if you see that. So, you know, the relevancy has to be matched. The theme has to be matched when you are doing the URL mapping. Similarly, the Gurgaon one again to the Gurgaon related. So for one URL, there are two keywords which are matched or targeted. Property in Gurgaon and real estate in Gurgaon. These two keywords, which are Gurgaon related one, are targeted on the Gurgaon related page. So how do you, so it's all a generic sense of, so you would pull out those keywords first. We did the keyword analysis. I got the keyword. After getting the keyword analysis done, I got those 15 keywords for which I wanted to do the optimization. Every page other keyword, right? For every page there is a different URL. So for every web, every keyword. So right now the step one was to list down the overall keywords first. After listing down overall keywords, I started mapping which web page of my website matches to this. So I had an Indore related page where I had got the Indore related one URL. I had a Bhopal related page. I got the Bhopal related URL. I got the Gurgaon related page. So how to get URL? By going each, absolutely, there is no other way. Yeah, you're not getting it. All right, so Santosh asked me the question which you have. So you have your website, your client's website is present in front of you. Your clients, first of all, tells you, you know, you have, let's say, given 80 keywords to your client. After doing the keyword analysis, you tell your client that these are the 80 keywords which I feel for which your business has got the relevancy, and your business should target these 80 keywords. Now your client will say, can I target all these 80 keywords? What happens in a real time scenario, I'm telling you, it happened with this particular client also. I told him that 80 keywords would mean these many rupees, let's say 80,000 rupees per month. I charge as per the number of keywords. I told him that I would charge 1,000 rupees per keyword per month. He said, no, I don't have that budget. You know, certain times there are budget restrictions also. He told me that I can pay you 15,000. So I told him that please select 15 keywords out of this entire 80 keywords lot. The overall 80 keywords I had got from that same list, you know, this list overall from the keyword planner. When I have got the 80 keyword list. Client has selected 15 out of those 80 keywords, and I had taken those 15 keywords right up over here. After getting these 15 keywords, I started looking into my website, what all web pages are there on my website, and which web page matches to which particular keyword. So let's say there were a lot of particular pages. I had a Mumbai page, I had a Delhi page, I had a Sikkim page, I had a Kashmir page, I had a Bangalore page, but there were no keywords which my client had selected related to Bangalore or Mumbai or Delhi. There were keywords which were selected for the Noida one. I would check into my website manually and see where is the Noida related keyword URL. And I would see for the Bhopal related keyword, which is the Bhopal related URL. And then I would start mapping. Audio gone. Is that for everybody else? Can you guys hear me? So I can see that it's not gone for me. All right. No. All right. Okay. So it's not gone. All right. All right. Okay. Thanks. So Guru, probably you might have to check at your end. So does that clear your question, Santosh? Somehow I'll go further and then you'll get to know how the overall mapping. All right. So for e-commerce, it will be done for every product. Absolutely, Pankaj. For e-commerce, it will be done. So this was a sort of e-commerce site also, Pankaj. So they were trying to actually give a link to, I mean, a semi-e-commerce, you can say. They were selling properties based in Noida, and they had the price tag also up. And if somebody has to buy them, then they would have to just click on instead of buy now, contact now button. So they had plenty of website, plenty of products. They had not got their website, every product URL mentioned. So Pankaj says, okay, Vibhor says there are again broad and location specific property. Absolutely, you could have taken that also. So the client didn't mention that, client didn't go for that. There can be much more longer key phrases also. You're absolutely right. Stosh says maybe when you show it practically, this is the practical only. This is not the theoretical part which I'm showing you. This is the practical only. Let me show you the website. How to register on URL. When you say register on URL in the sense, so Pankaj says, no, I know, but I want to know about e-commerce site having lakhs of products. I know all those who have having lakhs of products, you can't really escape out of it. If you want much better Pankaj search engine optimization, then you really need to have a good number of people working around it. Otherwise, there are certain formulas or there are certain programs which are run where they will take the content, they'll pull the content automatically from some other website and they'll put it on your website. But they generally don't get much better result. If you ask me, I have got people in Amazon, I've got people in SEO team in Snapdeal also, they all do it manually. If you do it, Pankaj, manually, the results are awesome every time. I know it's a bit, a huge pain. It's a huge pain to do it manually, but the results come in that way only. So, Vibhor says, how to register on URL? When you say how to register on URL, I'm not getting you. Can you explain your question, Vibhor? Guru says, you have selecting what's different for best property. All right. Because of the content which was over there in the what's different page, we had written something about best real estate, websites, best property website. The content was related to the keyword. That's why. All right. So, I mean, Santosh, how do I make you understand? I have got the keywords listed over here, and then I've got the URLs listed by myself by going onto the website and checking for all the URLs which are present on my website. So let's say, these are the keywords, these are the pages. So only 2-3 keywords for every page, right? And how, what was your question? Type in the entire question, Vibhor. You've written only 2-3 keywords for each page question. I couldn't understand your question. But now I have seen that every website is geographically specific website. Yes, many people are doing it. You're absolutely right, Nathan.
So before how to register on URL, I have to scroll up and then see what you said earlier and what you're saying now. How to register an URL on 2-3 keywords. All right, I'll show you that. I'll show you the practical way. So I'll come on to that by using a particular, plugin called SEO Yoast within our WordPress website. Once the URL mapping is done this way, there is another way also, just to say, there is another way also to work on the website part, sorry, the URL mapping part, which is, let me show you that. So in the earlier example, what I had done, so Mithun said, if you're searching property in Noida, then keyword will be Noida property. Yeah, keyword would be related to that. If you can finish this first, yes, I'm finishing it. So this is another way of doing URL mapping. Probably this might also make things much more clear. In this example of URL mapping, I made things turn in the other fashion. Instead of coming up with the keywords first and then mapping URLs against the keywords, I got the overall URLs listed of my website in one go. I got the homepage listed, written, then all the internal pages, you can see. I had written all the internal pages of my website written first. So it's not the keywords first, it's the URLs first, which I have written. After doing that, just ignore the title tag part, guys. You can see the targeted keywords. There are three keywords. There are three keywords which I have written one after another. So there is, they're separated by commas. So, and go to next would be better. Absolutely, yes, that's what I'm doing. So if you see, for the second URL, the third, fourth, fifth, for every URL, I have got three keywords which I have selected by myself on the basis of theme. I have bunched up, I have grouped three keywords. I have grouped three keywords and made them targeted for a specific URL. So you can see the Noida related one has got three related Noida related keyword, which is real estate projects name list, list of real estate projects in Noida, list of real estate developers in Noida, right? So now you were showing something on your client website. Okay, with the client website, these are the web pages. So, okay, I scroll further down. I have taken what I was trying to tell you from the client's website, that I have taken all of these URLs by going ahead and taking all of them step by step. I have to take all of them step by step. So most of the URLs are actually there on the bottom. So let's say this is luxury apartments in Gurgaon. I've taken this URL and I would take 2 to 3 keywords and would name them, would actually see from my entire list, are there any bunch of keywords which are around the Gurgaon location? Are there any keywords which are related to the luxury apartments kind of a theme? So I have to club keywords, I have to break up keywords or group keywords as per the theme. So I have to make them into groups of three keywords. Group of three keywords would be targeting every single URL. Every single URL will have a group of three keywords. Is that making sense? Why am I doing that? Because it will give you much better results. So I'll go further ahead and then make you understand more. So you can see for the homepage, there are three keywords. And then similarly, for every single URL, there are three keywords which have been selected, right? I did the other way. I got the list URLs listed first, and then I got the keywords connected to them, keywords mapped to them. In the previous example, it was the other way. I can do it the way I want to. I had the keywords listed first, and then for every keyword, I got the URLs mapped to them, right? The next thing, once we are done with the URL mapping, is to actually go ahead and change and create
tags for every web page. Now, what are tags? I will show you first that, and then how do we change them? I'll show you that also. So going back, so I have this search command where I type in, so have you taken the description of first paragraph? Which paragraph you mean? And where have I taken it? I'm sorry, I'm not getting you. From website, and where have I put in? So first paragraph from the web page I have taken, and where have I taken it? In that Excel, no, I have written that by myself, and I have, where have I posted it? I'll tell you that. So it's not from the web page. It's not from the web page. So guys, for every particular page which ranks up, so let's say this is a Snapdeal one. Okay, I open it in a new tab. I am telling you some of the things which are there, which every search engine optimizer have to really look at. And they are called tags, guys. Let's say for this particular website, if I have to see the backend of this website, the code of the website, I can do that simply by clicking right on the blank space. I've clicked right on my mouse, and then there is view page source, or the other way is to actually do control U. If I do control U or view page source, you would get to see the entire content, the code of the page. And within this code, guys, the things which we as search engine optimizers would change are these, which is the title tag. If you see, there are 2 to 3 things which we would be changing. One is this, the title tag, guys, and the other one is the meta description. All right. And the third one being the meta keywords. So you just need to mug that up, that they have used a lot of meta keywords over here, but it's not recommended. Having only maximum 3 keywords is something which is recommended. So those 3 keywords which I had mapped, they would come in the meta keywords, guys. And what are meta description and what are title tag? Let me show you that. So this is the search result of that same web page which I had opened the backend. If you see the content written over here on the top in the blue, navy blue colored, this is the title tag, guys, of every web page. This is the title tag. The blue colored thing of every web page is the title tag. Every time the title tag has to be written by the search engine optimizer, and it has to be in sync with those 3 keywords, you know, majorly those, that theme of the URL which we are talking about. If it's a Noida related one, then the Noida related title tag has to be written. If it is a Gurgaon related one, then the Gurgaon related title tag has to be written. You know, the keyword has to come into it. Now the title tag comes over here in the search results, and the meta description comes in this gray colored text. This gray colored text, guys, has the meta description. Now the major difference between these two tags, and where do they appear on the page? Let me tell you that. If I go into the front end, I'm repeating, title tag is this, repeating again on the top, and meta description is the one which is in the gray colored. All right. This is actually something which is not seen in the front end of the page. Over here, nowhere you would get to see the title tag and the meta description. The way you can see title tag is by just placing your cursor on the top of the tab of the page. If I take it over there, can you see this box which comes up, iPhone 6 16 GB, with this black background, sorry, white background and black color text, where, so it has disappeared just now. I'll take my cursor again and you'll see the title tag again, right? So the title tag comes in again over there. So iPhone 6 16 GB, buy Apple iPhone 6 16 GB online at low price. So Guru says, I had heard that Google robots will see the first paragraph to show the results based on the keywords. Is it right? In search result, we can see the first part of the particular blog. It's a content also, and Guru, it's a title tag also. Reboot say yes, bots. I am sorry. You're saying yes to bots. In search result, we can see the first paragraph. The first paragraph in the search results are mentioned, Guru, only when the meta description is missing. if nobody has, if the search engine optimizer has not written the meta description, then only the first paragraph comes in the meta description. You can see in the overall, this particular example, the first paragraph which is over here, any content which is over here, it's not that one which is appearing in the meta description. It's the same one, iPhone 6, 16 GB, blah, 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 which has been presented in the meta description. And the meta description is this. Video lag, all right, I'll just be slow on that part. So, I mean, yes, Google crawlers will crawl onto site to check your content. Yes, they would crawl onto your website. They would definitely come onto your website, check for the content. But the point which Guru says is that in the search results, the content of your website would come. The content of your website will come in the search results only when the meta descriptions have not been put in. But over here, the meta descriptions have been put in. It's always good to have meta descriptions in place. Many people leave it blank. All those people who leave the meta description blank, their content of the web page comes up. The content on their web page of their web page actually comes in the search results. But over here, you can see the meta description which is put in, which is iPhone 6 colon buy iPhone 6 16 GB online at best price in India. Same stuff is something which is in the search result, right? You would see the same thing. iPhone 6 by iPhone 6 16 GB. Guru, I hope that does answer your question. So, this is how to add meta. Absolutely, I'll come on to that. Right. So, Dhruv, do you have a question? You've written something. Tejin, this is different between meta. Absolutely, I'll tell you. Now, what's happening? First of all, let me know, Guru, did that answer your question? Vibhor, does that answer your question? And Pritham, I'll definitely answer. Santosh, are you clear? Any doubts? These are certain elements, guys. This is something I know a bit difficult to understand, but this becomes backend, how it is on page. Yeah, on the backend part, I'll just show you. On the backend part, how these things would actually differ. So I believe Guru is busy doing some Googling around or something. So you told that keyword density is 1%, absolutely, but Snapdeal is using iPhone 6. Many times, absolutely. These guys are doing a lot of stuffing, which is not right. You're right, Guru. But I hope your first question, your earlier question, Guru, has been answered. Your first paragraph gets appeared in the search result only if meta description is not been written by you. So Dhruv says the image comes on website, that text written on it, what it is called, the title tag. That is called the title tag. That image which on the website, that text written on it. All right, so you got that, Guru. All right, so now the difference between these two tags, guys, first of all, the title tag has to have a character limit of 55 to 70 characters max. The space is also counted as one character, guys. So 55 to 70 characters, I'll pass on these presentations to you guys. The presentations do have what I'm talking about. So I'm talking about title and meta description, and I'm going to talk about the other stuff also. Keyword research, I've already spoken about. Title tag is this. So 55 to 70, even if you do it in between 50 to 60 characters, that's also ideal. But don't go beyond 70 characters, guys. All right, just a second. All right, this is the one. So this is one thing. So title tag has a description limit, has a limit. Less is good, is it? No. Optimum is 50 characters, not lesser than 50, not more than 70. Even if it goes lesser than 50, then it's not good. If it goes beyond 70, it's not good. Anything between 50 and 70. And then meta description, guys, has a limit. Meta description limit is between 150 to 156 characters. So anything somewhere close to 145 character is also good. So 145 to 156 is what I would say. Now 150 to 156 is what Google says, but I have seen even 145 is also good. 145 to 156. You can automatically see, because if you use the SEOs when we blog, it will absolutely.
I'll come on to the SEO part here, right? So you can see this text is much more, right? It's occupying a lot of space and the title tag is not occupying a lot of space. Another thing is that title tag, difference between these two is that title tag is all about what the web page is saying, what the web page is all about. And meta description is mostly about, meta description is mostly about what are the new offers, some exciting stuff, or some promotional stuff. So you can see over here, it says free shipping, COD and EMI options, all that stuff across, right? So something which will really entice the end customer to go ahead and click on the search result, right? That's what meta description in, should have. Plus the meta keywords, which I told you, meta keywords, guys, are those three keywords which you should target for every web page. Three keyword for every URL which you're typing in, those are the meta keywords. Now there is another thing, guys, which is called focus keyword. Now focus keyword is one keyword out of the three total meta keywords. The three total meta keywords out of those three, if you would try to judge and just select one of the keywords, you know, a sort of a priority has to be done. Out of three keywords, you're just prioritizing and selecting one keyword that would be used as a focus keyword, and we'll use that. I'll show you online right now on the back end how this is being done. While going ahead on the same sheet, if you would see those three keywords which I had selected for every web page in that Excel sheet, I had written title tag, guys, I had written meta descriptions. And keeping in mind the objective, what meta description fulfills and what title tag fulfills, plus what the character limit of title tag is, what the character limit of meta description is, plus the focus keyword, which I've told you, one of the keyword out of those three keywords should be used at least once. Only once, not at least, at most once your focus keyword should be used in title tag, and at most once it should be used in that meta description. So Vibhor says, do you need to know web page designing to do? No, you don't really. I'll tell you how to do that. So if your website is in CMS, you can simply go ahead and do that. Otherwise, then you should be knowing development, or you would need a developer to go ahead and change that stuff, right? So are we all good as of now with the meta description stuff, guys, and the on-page other stuff, which the tag stuff? Got it, says Vibhor. Dhruv says yes. All right. How about others? Guru says yes. All right. Nitin says yes. Nand Kumar says yes. Tejendra says yes. All right. Anybody else? Santosh, still waiting to hear from you. Are you not good? Let me know. All right. Are you around? So trying to get it. Sure. No worries. If you still have problems, I'm always there to answer your questions and assist you in that. So Ashish, probably you would be okay with it. You might already be knowing about it. Rajiv. So how do you get the website icon? That is actually in the settings, the website icon. That is called favicon. Not the favicall thing, but favicon. That's called favicon. Yeah. This thing. So you have the GoToMeeting. For your GoToMeeting, you have this icon. For Google AdWords, you have this icon. For Snapdeal, you have the SD. You can add by plugins. Absolutely. Yeah. You can add by plugins. All right. So like I said, when I have created, now other thing was to actually create these, you know, you have to do content. You have to write in content by yourself, guys. Content writing has to be done by yourself within that, for writing the title tags and for writing the meta description. Once you have written the title tag, meta description, you've got the meta keywords up, and now you would be looking at changing things implementing these things in your website. So let's say I go into my WordPress related website. So this is my website, guys. Let me show you. I'm just going to open the back end and the front end of my website both. Yeah, it's ca.ca, Canadian, right? So my business is registered there. No, Canada. CA as in Canada. All right. Yeah, California is a state, right? So this is the front end of my website. Let's say I go to the blog section of my website. Okay. I go to the, so Drupal, Joomla, they all are other CMS also. So Guru, when you say CMS, just like WordPress, you have Drupal and Joomla. They're pretty similar. CMS stands for Content Management System, guys. And these are certain online tools, you can say. CMS are online tools, content management system, which are used for managing websites. You know, the overall stuff on your website, they are managed by these particular tools, Joomla, WordPress, and all that. So I'm using WordPress at present, and I'll show you how to get that. So easy way to create website, easy way to manage website, absolutely, right. So this is one of the blog posts, guys. I had clicked on the blog post, the blog, and the very first blog post, let's say if I go ahead and try to edit that and try to do the on-page optimization for this, I've already got the content up for this particular blog, you know. Now I would be just doing certain on-page optimization for this. I go into the backend in the another tab, in a tab right next to it. This is the backend of my website. This is the WordPress backend of my website. On the left hand side, first of all, we would be adding a plugin, guys. I go to the plugin section and I click on add new, which is the SEO plugin which we would be adding in. I click on add new. And then I click on SEO Yoast. This is the most renowned tool, guys. No need to know coding, absolutely. SEO Yoast. This is the most renowned tool, guys, which is there in the search engine optimization industry. Once I type in that, it will give me the very first one. Since it's already installed for me, so that's why it's not letting me install. It says installed. For you, if you're doing for the first time, you would have to click on install now. It will say install now, click on install now. And then after that, go ahead and click on activate. Right, so it will ask you to activate it. So, sure, Dhruv, absolutely. So, you know, we type in the activate part, and once that's being done, what will happen for every website, for every web page, guys, the SEO Yoast plugin would get implemented. For every web page, the SEO functionality will come in. With the implementation of SEO Yoast, for every web page, the SEO functionality will come in. Let me show you how. So let's say I go to the blog post page. I click on all the posts. And I'm checking out all the posts. And the very first one is this, the local SEO one. All right. I go ahead and click on edit. I'm editing this page. When I go ahead and click on edit, you can see that's the backend of my website. The content which is right up here is the same content which is right up here. Isn't that? So if I make any changes to my content over here and update it, it will also get appear on the front end. If I keep scrolling further down, you would see the Yoast SEO plugin options have come in. That's what we had actually downloaded. But this particular functionality is coming for every blog post and every blog page, and it helps us to do on-page optimization. When we do on-page optimization overall, the ranking for our website actually moves up, right? You can see, I did tell you having a one focus keyword out of those three keywords, meta keywords. So I have selected one of the keywords, you know, meta keywords, I also have it right up here. I've got those three keywords listed up over here for this particular web page. For this particular web page, I had
from my Excel sheet, I'll take those three keywords which I have decided for this. And from these three keywords, I've got one of the keyword as my focus keyword. I've written down the focus keyword over here. And with the focus keyword, I have also written my title tag, my meta description. If I start writing something more in title tag, you can see it gives me a warning that I'm going beyond the character limit. I'm going beyond the 70 character limit. I can change that. So title tag needs to have the focus keyword. I have that. My meta description needs to have the focus keyword. I have that. My meta keywords does have one of the focus keyword. Similarly, guys, I need to have a focus keyword part of my web page or the blog page, whatever URL also. So you can see I can make changes to the URL also. You know, this is the URL, guys, of that particular page. How to make your local business rank higher on Google. If I check the controls U, if I do the source code, if I press in control U right now of this particular page, you would see the title tag and the meta description is over here. How to make your local business rank higher on Google, right? The meta description which I have written is also over here. The meta keywords which I have written, they are also over here, right? So all in all, that's the thing, guys, which we have selected and set up. So Santosh says we have sentence, but how it catches the keyword? I'm sorry, it is a sentence, how it catches the keyword? It catches automatically out of the entire sentence, or even if you're writing a bigger post, you know, Santosh, you're writing a particular paragraph, search engine will actually find out the keywords within the overall sentence which you're typing in. If you'll just type in keyword and then you leave it, it would not be considered good. You need to have something valuable stuff being written, something which makes sense, something which means value to the end customers also. So meta keywords are keywords, absolutely right, Vibhor. Yeah, meta keywords and keywords are the same thing. So does that answer your question, Santosh? Google will automatically pick up keywords from the sentences which you're writing in. All right. So you can see when I started doing all that on the back end, and I can also change the URL. So the way I can change URL is I have written the front end of my URL will always be fixed, which is the domain part, but the part which is underneath, you know, which is afterwards of the URL, that can be changed. But how SEO Yoast help? Okay. See, SEO Yoast has given you the functionality, Vibhor, to put in the title tag, to put in the focus keyword. It did tell you that yes, the heading part has got the focus keyword, the page title has got the focus keyword, the page URL has got the focus keyword. If I wouldn't have the focus keyword over here, let's say in the title tag, it will say no. If I'll update it, you know, it will say afterwards, let me update it. Let's say I updated without any title tag before. I don't have to check it myself. Before that, it didn't have. I had actually done it myself, absolutely. So I actually did that myself. And when you do it for the first time, okay, why it is not updated, right? Not, I know, I'm not sure. It would have set everything in red. Earlier, everything was in red, guys. I had myself optimized it. So I did that myself. So I mean the site before SEOs. Before SEOs, nothing was there, absolutely, from the SEO perspective. Yeah. So SEO Yoast is giving you all the you know, suggestions in terms of what needs to be changed. Are you doing good? So just as an example, it gives you a warning if you're going beyond the character limit, or it also gives you a red signal if your keyword is not part of the title, if keyword is not part of the URL, if keyword is not part of the content, if keyword is not, your focus keyword is not part of the meta description. In short, your meta description should have the keyword, your title tag should have the focus keyword, your URL should have the focus keyword, your content should also have the focus keyword. Right, so just a second.
So before SEO Yoast, there was nothing. So right now, what I have done, I have got my overall, keyword being part of the URL over here. You know, how to make your local business rank higher on Google. And every space between two words is being represented with the help of a hyphen. Every space between two words is being represented as a hyphen, as a good search engine optimization activity, guys. So you, for a search engine friendly URL, never ever use a special character like @ symbol or #symbol or *symbol or &symbol. That's what you overall good search engine friendly URL means, guys. Right? Are we all good with that? So another thing, guys, are the other tags, but I don't wanna. I think I should stop it here because it'll be quite a lot for you. I would want each one of you to actually go ahead and create a particular blog post. So this is my site. Yeah, is it like analyze your site? Yeah, this analyzes your site. This looks into your overall pages and analyzes whether the on-page is done perfectly or not. Also, it gives you the overall platform of doing the on-page optimization. So get your websites, guys, and within your websites, have the SEO Yoast plugin being installed. And also, and helps you, gives you an option to change. Absolutely, it gives you, giving you an option to embed the title tags which you want. I would want you to do, first of all, keyword analysis for your websites, for any, let's say, even if you don't have a website, you can do it for any other website. Do a keyword analysis. And after doing keyword analysis, do at least for 5 keywords, a URL mapping for 5 URLs at least. And start writing title tags and meta tags. Meta keyword, meta description, and also the title tag, a keyword URL, a mapping, keyword analysis. All that stuff, I would want each one of you to actually do it so that things are very much clear to each one of you. I hope it makes sense. It's 8:10. I know it's 15-20 minutes prior to before I want to wrap up the session because I feel it's getting way too heavy. SEO is a bit heavy, guys, as compared to the other modules, for sure. There's no doubt about it. So I don't want you to feel out of the place. Just go ahead and get this thing done. And next time I'll be able to showcase the other part of on-page optimization as well. Right, before that, after the session, Guru, sure, I'll do that. Yes, the session is getting recorded and I'm going to share with you the videos, the session videos, which you can see is on this particular URL. Right, so this is the URL, guys, where you will get to see all the latest videos, all the recordings. I have shared the URL with you. All right, and would request each one of you to actually share your feedback, please, if you can. So I've shared the feedback URL, please. So all those who have come in for the first time, it's very important for me to know feedback from each one of you as well and from everybody. So Vibhor, Tejinder, Santosh, Rajiv, Pritam, Nitin, Nandkumar, Guru, Dhruv, Ashish, and Anuj, if you can just help me with the feedback, guys, please. Thank you, Ashish. Can you do that? We'll do that. I would request if you can do that right now, Rajiv. Anuj, can you just help with the feedback, please? So I've shared the feedback link. Thanks, Dhruv, and thank you, Tejinder. Thanks, Guru. So, Anuj, Pritham, Nand Kumar, Ashish has done that, I believe. Everybody, if you can help me with the overall feedback, please. Santosh says done, Vibhor says done. Thank you so much, Santosh. Thank you so much, Vibhor, Santosh, Vibhor. Sure, Pritham. And Pritham, I hope you have filled up the feedback form. And Anuj, if Rajiv, you can also do that. Rajiv and Anuj, if you can help me with the feedback, please. All right. So whatever queries, whatever doubts you guys have, I hope, I know most of you are connected with me on WhatsApp. So you can let me know and I'll try my level best to answer your queries. And I'll upload the recorded session, guys, and then we'll take it from there. All right. So Tejinder, you can connect with me. I hope you're taking sessions from Manjeet, right, Tejinder? Is that so? I'm not really sure. All right. Okay. Yeah, because I saw your name there. All right. Perfect. So how was the session? Just let me know, guys. So we have missed YouTube marketing. Okay. I'll surely take that. No, I think we did that. We did that, Santosh. Did we? Or we? Okay. Okay. That was with the other batch. We have to. So we haven't missed. It's yet to come. So we haven't missed. After SEO, the social media marketing is yet to come. So have you, where you would have all the YouTube, Pinterest and all that. So have you checked websites? I'm not getting sites. I'm not getting titles. Oh, okay. Just remind me once. Just remind me once. I'll do that. So remind me tomorrow. I'll do that. All right. Thank you so much, Nitin. And thank you guys so much for being part of the session today. I am... So the certificate, you just have to wait for that. So once you would be done with this overall course, by then you would be getting the certificate. Absolutely, I'll help you with that. So still a lot of time to go. Yeah, Dhruv, I'll talk to you about that. So Vibhor says domain name. Sure, Vibhor, WhatsApp me. I'll what domain name do you need? And I'll book that. So news of SEO, Anuj, majorly you can check for search engine journal.com and searchenginewatch.com. These two are major websites. I would recommend watching these two particular websites for overall news of search engine optimization industry on regular basis. All right. So thank you so much, guys, for joining in today. It was a pleasure having each one of you. And then I'll take your queries as in when so any different digital marketing, sorry, so please send me the recorded session. Tejinder, I did send you the URL. Just let me type that across once again. Save that URL with you, please. All the recorded sessions would be uploaded there. All the sessions would be recorded there. So Pritham says any different digital marketing and SEO. I'm not really sure. Thanks, Guru, for sharing that. So I'm not getting your question, Pritham. Any different digital marketing and SEO? Any difference in digital marketing? Digital marketing is a huge thing, Pritham. Digital marketing comprises of SEO, Google AdWords, comprises of social media, comprises of Google AdWords, email marketing, all that stuff. So digital marketing is a bigger thing and SEO is just a part of it. Right, and we are learning everything. We are learning everything over here. All right, guys. So I'll just take a leave. It's 8:17. Thank you so much. Do connect with me on WhatsApp for whatever doubts or queries you have, and then we'll take it from there. Perfect, guys. Thank you so much for joining in. Take care. Enjoy. Bye now. Bye. Bye, Anuj. Bye, Guru. Bye, Vibhor. Thanks.